And we all got divorced, and now our reputation is different. No one knows what to think. Hey, yeah.
You know, it's real. Divorce is real. Divorce. Divorce is real as fuck. Divorce is so real. I got divorced in the pandemic. It happened, you know? What are you gonna do? We both, one guy's happy. It's not like those stories that you hear regular comedians like, fuck that bitch. No, it just didn't work out. You know what I mean? And it's fine. And when you're married for so long, you're just used to certain things. I was dead asleep one night and I farted so hard. I farted so hard, I woke up ashamed, like, like this. And I looked over to my left and I apologized. And there was nobody there. I just turned over and cried. I was like, but I wrote that shit down immediately. I'm like, this is hilarious.
She gets a gig in New York, and we have a wedding in New York, and I fly to meet her at the wedding, and then we're gonna have this like really romantic weekend together. And we go to the wedding, and I don't know if you've ever been to a wedding with the person that you're dating, and you're watching the wedding, being like, is this like, would we? Like, I mean, I guess this little ring bearer girl's cute, but we would have like a dachshund in a white tuxedo hold the rings, right? And I'm watching the vows, and I'm just bawling. And then I look over at her, and she's crying a lot less. We go home after the wedding, and she's like, Nick, we have to talk. And I'm like, about what, the future? And she's like, sort of. And I'm like, what's going on? She's like, I think we should break up. And I'm like, what? What do you mean? We're great. She's like, no, Nick, we've been talking about this. And I'm like, we have not been talking about this. And she's like, well, I've been talking about it with my friends. And when you're getting dumped, you realize you are the last person to find out that you're getting broken up with. This person has focus grouped all of this. They have workshopped the material, and now they are presenting you with their findings, which is that you ain't shit, bitch.
I've got a good friend that has been through a divorce, and I've watched her go through this, and she's really doing well. She's doing great. She's quit eating bread, and she's doing sit-ups in the living room, and she looks like a movie star, and she wants a man. She's ready to get out there and get another man, and it is on like Donkey Kong. And I've sat here, watched her go through this, and I thought, oh, my Lord, if I had to get out here and get a man, at 57, after I've eaten all this Jell-O. Yes. It would take $1,000 just to groom. What all I've got going on. I've got a toenail that doesn't look right. We've got a girlfriend in our friend group, and she's 58, and she loves her husband, loves him. But we were saying, Lord, if we had to get out here and get a man, she said, okay, I think I could show somebody my left breast. She said, it still looks okay. I thought, where is my friend gonna go on dates? Where do people go on dates in their 50s and 60s? Lord, I have not dated since the 80s, honey. I want y'all to know that I can dance. I am coordinated and I'm athletic. I really am. I can bust a move. I'm not good at math. I can't do math. But I can bust a move. But if I had to go to a club, this is how I would dance now if I had to go to a club. Because I don't want to jiggle.
The other day, I watched a thick couple in rural Illinois do a custody exchange in the parking lot of a Hobby Lobby. To a Jason Derulo song. And I double tap for part two. I watch these two thumbs get out of their matching cherry red F-250, swap kids, and the dad looks at the camera like he's hosting American Idol and goes, "We're divorced, but we co-parent. How do we do it?" I'm like, "Probably a court order, Zeke." Double tap, part three. Then I watch them each get back into their truck next to their new spouse who, let's be honest, it's the middle of nowhere America, looked identical to the melted vanilla pudding cup they left in the first place. Real lateral trade if you ask me. And then I double tap for part four. It was a link to their family Etsy store. I bought a bandana. Shop small, America.
No, my parents aren't together. My parents split up when I was like 12. And then when I was 15, I found out. yeah. For a good while, I had no idea. Just one day, I went up to my mom. I was like, "Yo, where's dad been at?" And she looks at me like, "Oof, I knew I forgot something." Oh, man. And that's because growing up, I have a sister, and neither of us knew that he was gone. And that's because growing up, when he lived with us, he didn't hang out with us at all. And he was gone all the time already. So there was no real, like, emotional attachment to him. So it's kind of like this. It's kind of like, you know when you're at a party, and you're in a conversation with, like, two other people, and those two people, like, really engage in the conversation, and you're not really contributing, so you kind of just slowly just, like, walk out the conversation. And then start a new family. You ever do that? That's wild. Yeah. We still talk all the time. He just got a new job. He's currently a grade school bus driver, which is so silly to me, you know? Because it's like, okay, you wouldn't drive this kid to school, but now you won't drive everybody's kid to school. Okay, fine.
I say I don't want to be a mother, but I wouldn't mind being like a divorced dad, you know? I could crush that role, coming in hot at like 50% all the time. Yeah, showing up Friday afternoons with unicorn frappuccinos and then back to the Cheesecake Factory and then back to Starbucks and then drop them off and skedaddle Monday before shit really hits the fan. I could crush that role. Or a stepfather. That's another role I would crush. Nobody expects anything from you guys.
55% of marriages end in divorce. 90% of relationships that are started before they are 30 end. If those were the stats for surgery, none of us would fucking risk it. But because it's love and we're stupid, we just lie on the operating table like, maybe this time I won't die inside.
I'm afraid of being unsuccessful, to button up the shirt of life, miss a button on the way up, have to unbutton the shirt of life, rebutton it again. Right, to be older, poor, divorce, in a bar, paisley shirt, New Balance shoes. Talking to young women outside of my generation about things I don't care about or know about. Looking at a 25-year-old like, yeah, Dua Lipa slaps. I think a lot of men relate to that fear.
Look at all the relationships that end because no one talks. They hate to talk, and when you don't talk, that's when a relationship ends. And you know who hates talking? Guys. Because women love to talk. Just talk. And if you don't want to talk to her at that moment, then talk to somebody. Not everybody. Don't talk to your best friend. That's going to end the relationship too. Your best friend hated her. He's been waiting for you to break up. You're not gonna believe what she did. Oh, I already know. You don't have to tell me shit. She's always been that way, dude. What kind of advice is that? She's always been that way, dude. I didn't even tell you. You don't fucking need to, bro. Don't listen to that guy. Get the fuck away from him. Go to someone that doesn't know you or her. Get a therapist. Pay for it. $110 for the hour. Let that doctor figure it out. Why? You'll enjoy it, too. Walk into that room. Every guy will enjoy that. $110. Here, listen to what this bitch did.
So my wife, she wanted to go visit her parents one weekend, and her parents are divorced, and which has been hardest on me, to be honest. That's something people don't talk about, you know? When you marry into divorce, I mean, they divorced because of her, not me, so why do I have to go to 50 different houses?
Freaking love Hooters. My dad usually was the one that suggested we go there. I don't know how he and my mom ended up divorced. It's a mystery. But my entire family loved eating at Hooters. Even my mom liked eating at Hooters because you could buy a wheelbarrow of wings for $4. She's like, everybody's rich at Hooters. However, she wasn't always willing to admit that she liked Hooters. After my parents divorced, my mom started dating a very conservative, very religious man, the kind of man who stayed through an entire sermon and didn't leave to go to Chili's, let alone Hooters. To him, everything was a sin. So one night, we were trying to figure out where to go eat, and out of habit, I just go, oh, well, let's just go to Hooters. And my mom stiffens up. Because her man friend's right there. And she says, I have never eaten at Hooters. I go, what are you talking about? I have been to Hooters my entire life. Not with me. I have never been to Hooters. I'm like, you recruited my babysitter at a Hooters.
No, my husband, he is. He's a much nicer person than me. This is how you know. His ex-wife, they were married for 10 years. She cheated for the last 2 years of their marriage, right? And she never worked, which makes me so fucking mad. He never worked. He just paid for her to get multiple master's degrees in the French horn. I was like, wait, what? I was like, this bitch looks like Edward James Olmos. She got to sit home fucking tooting her French horn, eating snacks. I'm over here peddling my fucking wiener jokes from town to town. What kind of fucking bullshit is this? So I was furious, right? And this is the kicker, right? She cheated with a dude who plays, I think it's called a santor. It's like a Persian xylophone. I was like, you got cheated on with a dude that plays the dinky donks? That's fucking hilarious. I'm like, that's an unfuckable instrument. The French horn and the xylophone, there is nothing less fuckable unless he played the spoons on his mouth. Nothing else. And here's the kicker, right? Here's the kicker. So because she never worked, the guy she cheated with lived in Iran. So without my husband's knowledge, he was paying for her flights to go fuck this dude. Yeah, that's what I said. I was like, well, what'd you do when you found out? I was like, did you wrap that fucking French horn around her neck? I was like, did you set her shit on fire? And he got scared because he could see the instability in my eyes. He's like, oh God, no, why? April, why would I do that? Why? He's like, I knew that would hurt me a lot more than it would hurt her. He's like, I just want to have a peaceful separation. I knew the relationship was over. I just wanted to be amicable and go our separate ways. And I was like, oh. Okay. Well, just so you know, if you ever cheat on me, I'm gonna put a bomb-making pamphlet and a few lug nuts in your backpack. Yeah. Send you off to the airport. Good luck at immigration.
If you find the right person, of course, and lower your expectations of what you're gonna get out of it, you'll be very happily married. And I don't mean to demean it when I say lower your expectations. I really don't. I think that's why people get divorced. I think they have too high of an expectation of what they're going to get out of this one relationship. Eh, it's not that much. Don't put so much pressure on it. And keep your eyes open when you're going into it in the first place. Don't be dumb about it. Gotta be smart, you know? I have a friend that's thinking about getting married. He's so dumb the way he's talking. He's a moron. He's been with the girl for 5 years, and these things he talks about. She's nice, you know? Her family's pretty cool, you know? She's smart. But I don't know if she's hot enough. I don't know. Yeah, I'm talking about getting married. Is she hot enough? Are you high? Hot enough? You're talking about getting married for the rest of your life. You don't care about hot. You don't marry hot. You marry strong. You don't want a supermodel. You want someone who can pick up the other end of the couch.